Jim Morrison actually named his group The Doors from a mystical reference used first by William Blake and then later by Aldous Huxley. The Doors were just that, spiritual doors to the spiritual world. Morrison viewed himself as a shaman whose role it was to mediate between the demonic world and the counterculture of the 60s. Morrison encouraged them to break on through to the other side. He helped Satan initiate countless multitudes into the world of the occult. Satan picked out Morrison from a very early age and groomed him in the role that he would play to shape Crowley's counterculture revolution in the 1960s. Jim Morrison actually admitted becoming possessed at a very early age. In one song, he refers to the spirits crowding his young, fragile, eggshell mind. In an interview with Jim Morrison that appeared in The Doors' American Prayer album, Jim Morrison elaborates more on the possession experience that took place.
The reaction I get now, thinking about it, looking back, is that the souls or the ghosts of those dead Indians, maybe one or two of them, were just running around, freaking out, and just leaped into my soul, and they're still there.
Even Doors producer Paul Rothchild admitted, quote, "This spirit entered Jim's body. That was a pivotal event in his entire life. He always viewed himself as a shaman having mystical powers. It was this power that drove him and turned him into a seer." Here we see Jim Morrison on the front cover of The Doors album 13. And who is he with? None other than the Satanist Aleister Crowley. Jim Morrison echoed Satanist Aleister Crowley's satanic philosophy for the world revolution, "Do what thou wilt," with his own declaration that there are no rules. Morrison also stated, "I feel spiritual up there. Think of us as erotic politicians. I am interested in anything about revolt, disorder, chaos, especially activity that has no meaning." Here we see a picture of Jesus Christ with his disciples at the Last Supper. Below this picture, we see Jim Morrison and his disciples with Aleister Crowley, apparently drawing the conclusion that just as Jesus Christ had his apostles, Aleister Crowley the Satanist has his disciples as well. Jim Morrison recognized that as a songwriter he was only a vehicle, and that he and the rest of the Doors were only open and willing mediums to other forces that were using them.
"I can't say too much about it because we're not really making it, it's just kind of making itself."
Morrison said of the picture that you see before you that he felt he looked pretty satanic. In Morrison's song The Soft Parade, he reiterates the theme of selling one's soul to Satan for power and fame. Quote, "You gotta slay a few animals at the crossroads." For Jim Morrison, the crossroads would be UCLA and Venice Beach. After bombing on the finals at UCLA on film, Morrison went down to Venice Beach to live. It was there that Satan would offer him fame and power and fortune as a rock star if Morrison would do his bidding. It was there at Venice Beach, as Jim lived on the roof of an old abandoned building, that Satan communicated music to Jim Morrison, who couldn't even sing at the time, through visions. It was here that Jim Morrison opened his heart up to Satan's vision. Jim Morrison admitted of this experience. In that year, there was an intense visitation of energy. He said, "I left school and went down to the beach to live. I slept on a roof. I met the spirit of music." Who was that spirit? He said, "An appearance of the devil on a Venice canal. Running, I saw Satan." The material that Satan would communicate to Jim Morrison on Venice Beach would become the basis of The Doors' first two albums and would be far more powerful than anything that they would make subsequently to that time. Morrison said, "I was living in this abandoned office building, sleeping on the roof. I just started hearing songs. I heard in my head a whole concert situation with a band and singing and an audience, a large audience. Those first five or six songs I wrote, I was just taking notes at a fantastic rock concert that was going on inside my head." Jim Morrison, who was incredibly shy and could not sing a lick, went through a demonic transformation on stage as the demons that possessed him sang through him. Ray Manzarek, The Doors keyboard player, points out that Jim Morrison was a shaman.
"Jim's contribution to music was that Jim was real. Jim was real on stage. Jim was real when he wrote his songs, when he sang his songs in the studio. He was not a performer. He was not an entertainer. He was not a showman. He was a shaman. He was possessed, man. He was possessed, man. Possessed, man."
Manzarek also stated, "On stage, Morrison came alive and was the most exciting and dynamic performer I'd ever seen. He would go through trips on stage. You wouldn't believe the personalities that would come out of him, the intensity that would speak to the audience." Manzarek went on to say, 15,000 people would just be hushed, stopped, not even breathing. "Man, when I was on stage with the guy, I don't know what was playing the organ. Sure, it was my fingers, but..." implying that the same forces that took control of Jim Morrison took control of his fingers. Manzarek further stated, "When the Siberian shaman gets ready to go into his trance, all the villagers get together and shake rattles and blow whistles and play whatever instruments they have to send him off. It was the same with the Doors when we played in concert." He said it was like Jim was the electric shaman and we were the electric shaman's band, pounding away behind him. It would take him over. I could hit a chord and make him twitch, and he'd go off again. Sometimes he was just incredible, just amazing, and the audience felt it too. Here we see Jim Morrison doing a shamanistic dance as he sought to open himself up to the spirit world and let the demons use his body. Historically, Satan and demons have used shamans to influence primitive tribes throughout the world. This is similar to the shamanistic dances done by shamans, witch doctors, and voodoo priests throughout human history. The only difference is that Jim Morrison was not simply influencing one tribe, but his music has been used to influence generations and the masses. Like voodoo priests who become possessed as they surrender their bodies to the demonic beings, Jim Morrison exhibited very similar behavior throughout his performances. In the seance, the shaman led, Morrison said, a sensuous panic deliberately evoked through drugs, chants, dancing hurls the shaman into trance. Changed a voice, convulsive movement, he acts like a madman. Jim Morrison understood the process that took place as demonic beings took over his body. Concert footage of the Doors' performances gives ample evidence to Manzarek's assertion that different personalities would manifest through Morrison while on stage. In fact, at times one could hear two or three different demonic beings manifesting through Jim Morrison's body, like the following clip expresses.
No. Run to the mirror in the bathroom, look!
Jim Morrison biographers in the book Break On Through point out that he was, quote, opening himself to be used and abused by any spiritual entity that happened to come along. The result may have been some amazing inspirations, but also a tragically restless and misdirected life. Incredibly, the same spirits that brought Mr. Mojo Rising, as he liked to refer to himself, up to power, also brought him down to destruction. These same demonic beings that used Jim Morrison's body as a puppet to influence the masses would later discard it, as he would die only months after the death of Jimi Hendrix and Janis Joplin. Jim Morrison admitted that he had to drink to silence the constant voices of the demons who were tormenting him. Frank Lisiandro, Doors photographer, stated that, quote, "Jim drank to quiet the ceaseless clamor of the demons, ghosts and spirits begging for release. He drank because there were demons and voices and spirits shouting inside his head, and he found that one of the ways to quell them was with alcohol."